One. All right, we are back here with Adam from the Classy Dicks and his own stream, and we're waiting.
I'm here with Kyle, and we are gonna open this door.
All right.
Access denied. Scans reveal subject is a cat wearing a birthday cap.
I don't think so.
I'm 37.
Nice. What the hell is this? It's fucking Grumpy Cat. Who lives in Arizona, by the way?
Really?
Yeah, he does.
I had no idea where Grumpy Cat lived.
Yep, he lives in Arizona.
That's awesome.
We need to redo the contract.
Oh, yes, we do.
So I found out why we need to do this.
Why?
We have an invisible dude. Okay. Every time I put a point in something that affects our contract, it goes away.
Oh, really? Oh, because yeah. I gotcha.
Scans reveal subject is a racist hot dog.
I don't know who they're making fun of now.
I'm sure the racist hot dog workaround would work.
I don't like these
trucks. I don't even know what that's supposed to mean.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like these trucks. Trucks against looking at our hamsters. Moss punching trucksicans. I got to listen to my dad have a racist anti-immigration rant yesterday. Yeah.
Did you talk to him on the phone, or did he come down?
No phone. Okay. He lives in Ohio.
All right. Yeah, I wasn't sure if maybe he took a trip down.
No. Killing you is also very dangerous, incidentally. About fucking time. Yeah, I don't think my dad will ever come to Arizona. Mm-hmm. He's very old and not in great health.
I gotcha. Because sometimes my I live near my grandmother now, so I usually instead of helping my family, I help my more extended family, and we were talking one time and she kind of went on a
racist rant.
It's racist, but it was kind of like a old nice grandma racist rant. Like, kind of a this is just how she grew up, so it's the only thing she knows type thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't with malice, it was just kind of like the words she used.
Jack's here, by the way.
Oh, yeah, he is. She didn't throw out the N-word or anything, but...
Oh, my dad did. Yeah, no, my dad didn't do that. It was mostly, we can't have an open country, blah, 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 blah. I don't want to pay for their health care, blah, 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 blah.
Oh, right.
And I just sat there going, uh-huh, uh-huh.
And how. Yeah, you don't want to piss in people's cereal too much, but, I mean, sometimes you just gotta let people talk.
Absolutely. I think that's the story of streaming in general.
Maxim Turner, Alma Heron, Lawrence Quit Kid?
We have to go to research and development now.
Okay.
Which I guess there's a fast travel to, yes.
Sweet.
Hyperion Hub of Heroism. Have you seen the awesome gunfight that happens in the Hall of Heroism? In the Tales From?
I don't think so.
Oh my god. It is the best.
Is it?
Oh my god, it is.
I'm sad that I missed it. That sounds like the laser doing things. Oh, the laser is doing things.
Is it?
It was.
Oh, it's didn't even take... Yeah, yeah, it is right there.
It's right there.
Look at that galaxy over there.
Yeah, I like it. Is that Milky Way galaxy?
I don't know. They've never said where the Borderlands series takes place.
Yeah. Looks like Elpis is getting kind of fucked.
Yeah. I can imagine.
Yeah. Well, I mean, huge laser pointed at it, shooting at it.
Shooting at it consistently, yeah.
Yeah, that should've happened.
Yes. So, do you remember in the first episode of Tales from the Borderlands where they're, like, making fake guns at each other?
Yes.
It's a...
Oh, yes, I did see that.
With, like, the guy that comes out with, like, the rocket launcher.
Yep.
It's great. I loved it. Every minute of it. And everyone's like, oh, that's dumb. Like, you guys are humorless fuckwits.
Yeah.
Here's a thought, Sarpa Derp. Why don't you just not destroy the moon and kill hundreds of innocent people?
Hundreds now to save, millions later. And my name is Zarpadon. Tungstena Zarpadon.
Tungstena Zarpadon. You must have been super popular in high school. My god, your parents were assholes.
What were you gonna say? I'm sorry.
I can't even remember. So everyone that was dying in that fight was just like play dying, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because I actually think when I was watching Mike play, I jumped in and I wasn't sure if there was some sort of, like, actual thing that was going on that Hyperion invented some sort of crazy, invisible shooty gun.
No. Luckily. Okay. Yeah, no, it was all fake. All fake death. As far as I know.
Right. Yeah, in the next episode they'll be like, and everyone died.
Come find me, but be careful, the Torks broke out of their cages.
Of course they did.
Fucking Torks.
Of course they did.
Nothing's easy.
Nothing. Never.
This whole wing is bad. It's like the wildlife preserve.
Yes, it is exactly like that. Unfortunately, luckily we went to fight fucking Bloodwing.
Yeah.
That fight sucked.
And I don't think they ever fully fixed the glitch where if you kill him out of the arena, the items just go flying.
Yeah, I don't think they ever bothered.
Because he dropped his loot, there was a sniper rifle in his loot table that I always wanted. And I'm fairly certain I saw it, and it fell to a place where I could not even try to get it.
Yep, sounds about right.
And it made me very sad. And that's the story of Adam, and the loss of his sniper.
I was gonna say, is that just the story of Adam? He's always sad.
Adam is not always sad. Adam is always happy.
You're like the non-salty person of the salty dicks.
The salty dicks, yep. Yeah, why'd that thing just have your face on it?
Okay, so that's the thing I just got. Let me read it out real quick to you. Because we were just busy doing stuff. So... It's called Save the Queen. Okay. When an enemy melee attacks you, they become marked with Save the Queen. If your servant damages a marked enemy, that enemy suffers cryo damage and the mark is consumed. Your servant may also trigger Save the Queen once every few seconds. Save the Queen does not function without a servant.
Okay.
So you can just trigger Save the Queen every once in a while, or if they do a melee attack, which most enemies seem to.
Yeah. This thing is like a dragon.
What's like a dragon? Where are you?
Oh, it's a stalker. I didn't even realize that.
Let me come over there.
It just looks slightly different. It's also dead on a table.
Yes. No, that totally looks like a stalker.
Yeah, then I looked at the thing and I'm like, oh, hey.
Yep, stalker.
Stalker.
There's a skag, another stalker, and there's skag. You like skags?
I love skags.
Skags. Oh, I was making a reference.
Oh.
Have you not seen Snatch?
I have seen Snatch, but it's been a while. And the,
I would say, if you haven't seen Snatch, then we need to fix that.
No, I've... I actually... I watched it fairly recently. I just can't remember that line.
It's when they're with the gypsies.
Oh, alright. The Cockney guy. Not the Cockney. They're gypsies, yeah, but... When every time he talked, I always imagine it was Cockney, because every time I hear about Cockney, it's a...
A rhyming slang.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's not Cockney, it's, Oh, yay! Another gun! That's awesome, I'm so happy.
Yeah. Alright, I like this. Alright. So I have shotgun. Let me use a laser. This one. Oh, yeah.
Retrieve scientists. Oh yeah, this is absolutely the nature. Oh fuck, we're fighting.
Oh, fucking stalkers. They got a gland that produces a substance that bends light.
Fun little guys. God damn it.
Of all the enemies they had to reuse.
They had to reuse goddamn stalkers. Yep. I mean, we should have seen this coming.
With the dead stalker.
With his dead stalkers everywhere. Yes. God damn it. It doesn't mean I have to like it.
No. This is where I wish we had Zero, because going into Deception, you can see
the
blue
them.
Outline.
Yeah, my sister, that's why she always played Zero. One of the reasons why she always played Zero.
Fuck you, Stalker.
I hate them so much. But luckily, I have
The diadem?
The diadem, which should help a little bit, yeah.
Oh, hey. Are they jumping through there? Can they do that?
No, they can't. They can't phase.
It looks like they just jumped through a window. Maybe that's...
No, they can't phase.
Maybe it's just weird clipping.
Yeah.
Which wouldn't be the first time in this game.
No.
Oh,
cool.
Jack sent help. Well, I'd love to get out of here. Oh, it's totally fucking Ghostbusters.
Sorry.
It's all good. He's got a power pack on, and he looks like the black one, who I honestly can't remember.
The African American one. I'm kidding.
We'll be as politically correct as we need to.
Yeah. I don't care. we talk about like penises and stuff all the time. I don't think it's gonna be a problem.
I hope not.
Adam is the gayest straight person I know.
It is true. I just have no.
No filter?
It's not even so much no filter. I just think the whole. Because people don't joke about dicks as much, so I've made it my goal to joke about dicks more often than whatever.
Really? You think the dicks are the things that people don't joke about the most?
Not as much, but, I mean, people... I don't know. I don't know the best way to put it, but...
I think people think penises are, like, a constant joke.
Yeah, well, I mean, in general, you fucking see them. They're not the most distinguished of things. But...
No. I've never seen a penis and thought, you know what, I really want that. And yeah, I'm gay!
Yeah, it's more just I'll deal with it.
Yeah, I mean, men are like, oh yeah, those boobs are great. Which I don't get.
Yeah. They're pretty fantastic.
I mean, I understand. I understand that you would feel that way. But I've never had that compulsion with penises.
Right.
They're kind of droopy. They look like old men.
Fair enough. Never heard the old men analogy before, but
I mean, they're kind of wrinkly, you know, and they droop a little bit. It makes sense, trust me.
Like, I've seen a penis.
I would have hoped so. Hyperion sponsored DNA. Like I think that way about raisins too. Raisins and other dried fruit are like old people. They're all wrinkly and chewy, and that's just it's gross.
Oh.
Are you sure? I guess that might be Egon.
I come home without that, my son would have thrown his feces on the wall. you know how 19-year-olds are. Anyway, come on back. I got something for you.
Who's this?
What's son been doing anyway?
It's great. He's got a girlfriend.
Oh, wow, really?
No, I'm just kidding. He doesn't have a girlfriend. Not even close.
What a nice dad he is.
I know.
So is this not one of the scientists we have to retrieve, I guess?
Maybe we just had to get there?
I guess so. It didn't update, though.
No, well, because it told us that was our goal, and then... No, not so much.
Why are there so many fucking stalkers?
Oh, hey, badass stalker.
They already fucked. Already fucked.
So many of these bastards everywhere.
There's so many!
I know, and so invisible too.
Yes, they are indeed invisible.
I guess invisible-ish.
Yeah. God, I hate them.
I mean, theoretically, we have grenades. That's kind of an AoE that hopefully maybe means death.
Oh, God's sakes! Cryovine, god damn it. Yeah, we do have grenades.
Oh, wait, kill those bees first.
Bees?
Okay! Alright, that worked.
What the? Okay, I like it.
I might have thrown two grenades. Do you want the family photo or not or what?
Could I have that photo, please? Thanks. That ugly face gets me through the day.
Wow.
He does not like his son at all.
But he does.
He enough to get that thing, yes. Enough to not insult him with every sentence.
No. You're welcome. So there's one scientist retrieved. Was that a...
Au revoir. Save Dr. A honeycomb? Great.
Just rescue the I guess I said au revoir. To the
freaking beasts everywhere! I've lost my teddy bear.
Bring it back to me! Are we really just gonna be... Wow. What a pussy. They are really irritating, though, I will say.
Yes.
Oh, you scared me! Hello again!
Dr. Torres.
Yep.
Drain the aquarium! My teddy bear's on the other side! I'll let you into the aquarium section. But for real, so please be careful.
This guy reminds me of Dr. Wily.
A little bit, and we will go get his stupid teddy bear in the next episode.
Yeah, we will. Him and his stupid teddy bear.